Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Samuel 4:1-11. Now the Israelites went out to fight against the Philistines. The Israelites camped at Ebenezer, and the Philistines at Aphek. The Philistines deployed their forces to meet Israel, and as the battle spread, Israel was defeated by the Philistines, who killed about 4,000 of them on the battlefield. When the soldiers returned to camp, the elders of Israel asked, "Why did the Lord bring defeat on us today before the Philistines? Let us bring the Ark of the Lord's covenant from Shiloh, so that he may go with us and save us from the hand of our enemies." So the people sent men to Shiloh, and they brought back the Ark of the covenant of the Lord Almighty, who is enthroned between the cherubim. And Eli's two sons, Hophni and Phinehas, were there with the Ark of the covenant of God. When the Ark of the Lord's covenant came into the camp, all Israel raised such a great shout that the ground shook. Hearing the uproar, the Philistines asked, "What's all this shouting in the Hebrew camp?" When they learned that the Ark of the Lord had come into the camp, the Philistines were afraid. "A god has come into the camp," they said. "Oh no! Nothing like this has happened before. We're doomed. Who will deliver us from the hand of these mighty gods? They are the gods who struck the Egyptians with all kinds of plagues in the wilderness. Be strong, Philistines. Be men, or you will be subject to the Hebrews, as they have been to you. Be men, and fight." So the Philistines fought, and the Israelites were defeated and every man fled to his tent. The slaughter was very great. Israel lost 30,000 foot soldiers. The Ark of God was captured, and Eli's two sons, Hophni and Phinehas, died the crushing defeat despite the Ark. One of the most repeated warnings from the Lord was hypocrisies. The Lord persistently and openly criticized such hypocrisy of religious people. "Woe to you, teachers of the law and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You are like whitewashed tombs, which look beautiful on the outside but on the inside are full of the bones of the dead and everything unclean. In the same way, on the outside, you appear to people as righteous but on the inside, you are full of hypocrisy and wickedness." Matthew 23:27-28. Why was the Lord so strongly against the hypocrisies of the religious people? It is because he knew how detrimental such hypocrisy can be not only for themselves but to others and even to God. We see a good example of such truth in today's passage. Israel was still in deep spiritual darkness with the powerless spiritual leadership of Eli and the outright hypocritical and ungodly behaviors of his sons. Such spiritual weakness and hypocrisy may seem invisible to our eyes. But it often resulted in overall weaknesses of the individuals and communities. We see it in the repeated defeat of the Israelites as they encounter the invading Philistines. Israelites lost 4,000 soldiers in their first battle against the Philistines. The soldiers vaguely thought that such defeat had a spiritual reason. They said when the soldiers returned to camp, the elders of Israel asked, "Why did the Lord bring defeat on us today before the Philistines?" That seemed correct judgment. The battle ultimately belongs to the Lord. However, their view of God was so shallow and hypocritical that they came up with a deadly wrong spiritual solution which the Lord deplored so strongly. They decided to bring it to the Ark of God falsely, assuming that it will work as a miraculous victory for them. They presumed that God will fight for them if they only have the physical presence of the Ark, even though they didn't have any real faith and trust in the Lord. The Ark of God was brought to the battlefield by Eli's two sons, Hophni and Phinehas, who were priestly family outside but had no faith or fear of God at all. The result was one of the worst defeats in the history of Israel. Israel lost 30,000 foot soldiers. The Ark of God was captured, and Eli's two sons, Hophni and Phinehas, died. It was one of the most humiliating defeats for Israel and for God. The same thing can always happen to religious hypocrites who decorate themselves with flowery religious words and deeds that lack true faith and fear of God. Knowing such tragic outcomes, the Lord Jesus couldn't be silent. The same warning holds true for you and me. Are we not bringing the Ark of God without any faith and trust in Him? Are we not using His name in vain? Let us not forget the righteous anger and warning of the Lord.